No matter what the fence says, no matter what Gwen wants, Ethan is not going to take you away from him. He loves us both too much to ever hurt us like that. Mommy knows your daddy better than he knows himself, and you know what? He's going to come to live with us before he ever gives you to Gwen. I promise you. Honey, just think that very soon a baby is going to breathe life into this room again.
Staff did a wonderful job putting it together.
Oh, Jane is going to be so happy here. And I am going to be even happier to have a child in our lives again. And I know that Jane is your daughter with Teresa, but I promise you I'm going to love her as if she were my own, just like I did with little Ethan. Ever since he went back to live with Teresa, I have felt so empty inside.
I'd missed him, too.
I still can't believe that Teresa got custody of little Ethan because of some stupid clause in the contract we had with her when she was our surrogate.
Honey, let's not bring that up again. What's done is done.
Yeah, which you'd think would make her, you know, okay with you having custody of Jane since she has custody of little Ethan.
Well, honey,
but no, as always, Teresa has to make things different.
No, well, she's having a kind of a rough time accepting the fact that we have been granted temporary custody of Jane.
It looks like she's not the only one having a hard time with it, right? You're still not comfortable with taking Jane away from her.
Look, about this whole custody issue.
Oh, Ethan, please tell me you haven't changed your mind. You want Teresa to keep Jane?
Something you need to know.
That you're a thief, jerk, loser? Got it.
Will you shut up for a second?
Where's your good luck charm? Little Miss Hot to Trot.
Sandra had to leave.
Well, finally realized you're a zero, did she?
Look, I didn't come over here to fight with you, okay? I came to warn you. That guy who's getting you a drink, he's bad news.
Jealous, are you, Ned?
I mean it, Fancy. Get away from him before he hurts you.
¿Qué te pasa, Luis? You seem troubled.
Sheridan and I are fighting over Marty again. She still thinks that he's her son.
Even after the DNA proved that Beth is Marty's mother?
Oh, she thinks that the test is wrong, even though her friend Dottie ran the test.
Luis, what if the samples were tampered with before Dottie got to test them? I mean, remember, Alistair altered Chad's DNA test results so that no one would find out that he was even Julian's son.
I know. And Sheridan was on Alistair's case about that, too, and it turns out that the old man was up to no good with Beth, but just in a different way than Sheridan thought.
Wait. Alistair and Beth? I don't understand.
Well, Beth admitted that Alistair gave Beth money to try and break us up.
What?
I know. But Beth's conscience got the best of her, and she admitted everything. She couldn't go through with it. But Sheridan thinks that it's just a smokescreen, that her and Alistair really are working together, and that somehow the two of them managed to kidnap Marty and pass him off as her son.
Well, but did you remind Sheridan that, I mean, you've known Beth since before you were even in high school. In fact, if your father hadn't left us, you would be married to her right now.
Yeah, of course I told her. Just upset her even more. She feels like I've betrayed her, and I don't know what to do.
I knew. You should believe Sheridan, Luis. You should back her up 1,000%. Because if you don't, you are going to lose her forever. As soon as I find Dottie's number, I'm going to give her a call and talk to her about Marty's DNA test. I need to let her know that my father may have altered the results to make it look like Beth is a mother.
Be a bad little witchling, and Dora, help Mummy. Put Sheridan in a trance and help her to focus on proving that the DNA test was flawed.
found Dottie's number. She'll help me to prove what I know to be true. Marty is my son. Damn Luis for not believing me.
This is it, Indora.
Oh?
Yes. We are witnessing the beginning of the end of Sheridan and Luis's love story.
He's no friend to women. I knew an old girlfriend of his. She said he used to rough her up. And I don't mean for fun. The guy's bad news, so lose him now before it's too late.
No wonder you lose at poker. You're a lousy liar, Ned.
I'm really trying to help you here.
Help yourself to me is more like it. What your bimbo bailed, so you decided to play hero, thinking I'd dump a real man for you.
You're wrong, okay? You're full of yourself, and you're wrong.
Go back to playing old maid. I'm gonna have a good time tonight.
Changed my mind. I'm not going to let Teresa keep Jane. We were awarded custody. She's going to have to accept it.
Okay, good, because when you said you wanted to talk about this whole custody
thing, what I meant was now that Jane is going to be living with us, I want to allow Teresa to be included in my daughter's life.
Okay. Hey, listen, I totally understand that you're being magnanimous about Teresa, just like I was by not pressing charges against her for assaulting me in court. Right?
Exactly, exactly. I think if we're a little more inclusive with her, she will be more accepting of the situation.
Hey, the less drama, the better.
Good. Good. I'm glad you said that, because I think we should let Teresa just keep Jane overnight. I don't see why we would rush over there when she's probably just going to go to sleep. Ethan.
I'm sorry to call so late, Mr. Winthrop. I'm caseworker Mary Sams with the Harmony Department of Children's Services. The law requires that we meet to go over the final details of you and Mrs. Winthrop taking temporary custody of Jane Winthrop, your daughter, with Teresa Lopez Fitzgerald. Is 10 o'clock tomorrow morning good for you?
My wife and I haven't exactly taken custody of Jane yet.
The judge's order granted immediate temporary custody.
I know this.
A word to the wise, Mr. Winthrop.
Go get Jane tonight.
You have to be on Sheridan's side, Louise. No matter what.
But you say that like facts don't matter.
They don't matter. Love, Louise. Love is all that matters.
Okay, facts like a DNA test proving that Beth is Marty's mother matter. Now look, here's the thing. Sheridan thinks that Alistair and Beth are working together, even though Beth swore to me that she's not working with him.
And you believe her?
Yeah, I do. And that made Sheridan angry beyond belief.
Okay. Well, look, Louise, you don't want to focus on that. What you want to focus on is your love for each other. Not losing Sheridan over facts or proof. I mean, those things have nothing to do with being in love. All that matters is what's in your hearts.
It's not that simple.
It is that simple, Louise. You love Sheridan, right?
Of course I do.
Then ignore facts. Ignore proof, ignore logic, and all that police stuff. Hold on to your love for Sheridan, Louise. Believe her. Against all doubt, against all odds, if you don't, your relationship with her is doomed.
Good job in Dora. Sheridan's trance is downright bewitching.
Dottie, it's Sheridan. Sheridan! Oh, what a coincidence. I was just going to call you. Yeah, I'm back in Harmony to do research at the hospital for Boston General. How are you doing?
I've been better.
What's wrong? You don't sound like yourself.
I've been thinking about Marty's DNA test. I'd like to come over and talk to you about it. In private, as soon as possible.
You go, girl.
Sheridan, there's nothing to talk about. I told you the tests were accurate. If I ran them again, I'd get the same results. Beth Wallace would still be Marty's biological mother.
I would still like to talk to you about it again.
Since we're old friends, okay. I'll be at the DNA lab at the hospital. You can come by any time.
Great. I'll be there right away. I want to go to the hospital and see Dottie. Talk to her about Marty's DNA test.
You do that, dear. And get Dottie to redo the test if need be.
I will.
Another win for Team Tabitha. When Sheridan gets Dottie to redo the DNA test and Luis is proven wrong, she will never forgive him for having doubted her. And their love, which has burned so brightly for centuries, will end up on the ash heap of history. And I will finally get my place in the Witch's Hall of Infamy. Sheridan has a way to go before she gets to the hospital. Yes. So we have plenty of time to decide what we want to be snacking on. Miss Crane gets her reality bite.
No.
Oh, no, Catherine's in the park.
Oh, if Sheridan sees her mother, her trance will be broken.
And Dora, what are we going to do? Sheridan has to stay focused on rechecking that DNA test or all will be lost and her love for Luis will endure once more.
Teresa, you're wrong to think that I have to ignore the facts and logic to keep from losing Sheridan.
Luis, relationships are built on things that we feel in our minds and in our hearts, not things that we can see or touch or prove or disprove.
Okay, so if what you say is true, then why aren't you with Ethan?
I was with Ethan once, and I will be again.
No, Teresa. You see, fate and feelings have gotten you nowhere, and the fact is that Ethan is married to Gwen, and you ignoring that has gotten you into a world of trouble.
Your brother is right, Mija.
Now, isn't it true that Ethan warned you that he would take Jane away if you didn't drop the charges against Gwen?
He was pressured into doing that, Louise.
And his warning came true. Why? Because you ignored the facts, and now not only have you lost your baby, but you have lost the man that you love.
What's that all about?
Miss Sams, the social worker who is monitoring Jane's custody case, is going to be over here tomorrow morning to see how Jane is doing. She thinks it's best that we go get Jane tonight.
I agree with her.
Not sure I do.
Honey, listen, I know you think it would be easier for Teresa to have Jane overnight, and maybe it would be easier for her to relinquish custody to us then, but I think it's going to be just the opposite.
Honey, I hate taking Jane away from Teresa, all right?
Oh, my God. Don't even start this with me, okay? Seriously, Ethan, remember, she was the one who forced your hand. And besides, the longer we wait, the more likely it is that she's going to try and take both little Ethan and Jane out of the country, just like she did when Julian sued her for custody of little Ethan.
Honey, don't you think you're exaggerating just a little bit?
Don't you think you have selective memory when it comes to Teresa? She tried to take little Ethan to Mexico twice. And being that Teresa never learns from her mistakes,
What's to say that she's not going to pull some stupid stunt again? Another stunt that would keep the strike back thing going on and on. Ethan, you need to stop her. You need to stop her before she tries to deny you custody of Jane.
So what's the deal with you and this, Ned guy?
There's no deal.
And then why were you talking to him while I was getting our drinks?
I wasn't. Ned was talking to me.
And so why were you even listening after the way he disrespected you earlier?
I didn't want to embarrass you by making a scene. Ned blames me for his losing at roulette. I say let him blame me.
Smart move. He'll get over it once he wins back all the money he's lost. What do you know? Looks like a certain smug jerk back on a winning streak.
So he is. God, look at that cocky grin of his. Like he's a high roller. I wish someone would teach him a lesson. Bring him down so hard he'd have to crawl out of here.
I could teach him a lesson if you wanted me to.
Really?
Oh, it would be my pleasure.
It would be my pleasure to let you. I might even teach you a thing or two later tonight.
Deal.
Honey, I really doubt that Teresa's gonna try to flee the country with little Ethan and Jane.
You know, this is what drives me nuts about you, okay? Teresa said she would do everything she could so that we wouldn't get custody of Jane, and here you are standing here defending her.
I guess I just keep hoping that she's learned her lesson, that's all.
Okay, well, let's not just hang around and wait and see, okay? Let's go get Jane tonight so Teresa won't do anything to hurt herself or the kids. Besides, the social worker Olpe ordered you to take custody of Jane tonight, right?
Yeah. I hate this. I hate taking a child away from its mother, Gwen, but I understand. And you're right. So let's go get Jane.
Teresa, I'm sorry. Look, I didn't mean to burst your bubble about Ethan, okay? It's just, I'm a detective. My life revolves around facts and not just feelings. And Sheridan needs to understand that too, especially when it comes to Marty.
But Luis, I believe that you should be more understanding of Sheridan and what she's feeling.
I am trying, okay? I really am. It's just, she is obsessed with this idea that Marty is her son, and I can't accept that. I can't accept that any more than I can forgive her mother for luring Papa away from his family.
Sheridan. Rats and bats, Catherine Zena. Oh. If her trance is broken, then the DNA test will go unchallenged. And Sheridan's love for Luis will survive once more.
Sheridan, what are you doing out here so late?
I have to find the truth. Proof that Marty is my son.
Darling, are you all right? I wonder if Sheridan is sleepwalking again. Sheridan.
Mother.
Where are we?
Honey, we're in the park. Oh, that's right. I was on my way to see my friend Dottie at the hospital about Marty's DNA test. I still don't know how it could prove that Beth is Marty's mother when I know that she isn't. I am.
I thought all that was settled. That Beth confessed to taking Marty, that Luis went and got Marty and brought him back to the cottage.
Luis went and confronted Beth about the whole thing, and of course, you know, she lied about everything that happened. And Luis believed her. He believed Beth over me.
Oh, no, darling, I'm sorry.
He keeps saying that the DNA test is proof that Beth is Marty's mother. And I know that she isn't. I can't believe that he would take Beth's word over mine. I mean, I've never been so angry at Luis, so angry and hurt.
Darling, I'm sorry that you and Louise are fighting. I think you should go to him. I think you should talk to him. Honey, you two love each other too much to let anything at all come between you.
Mind your own bloody business, Catherine. If you play peacemaker to those two lovebirds now, I'll never be able to tear them apart. And my bosses will tear me apart, that's for sure.
Lesson you wanted me to teach Ned? No time like the present. I just have to go speak to a friend of mine first.
Ned, you were right about my friend being trouble. But for you, not me.
Hey, buddy, I need one of your special decks of cards.
Found an easy mark, did you?
Yeah, I'm gonna clean him out. I'm gonna get a little mattress time for my trouble.
Okay, let's go get Jane.
Okay, I think we got everything we need, so.
Yes, I will call to have your car brought around.
Okay, the sedan, not the convertible, okay?
Okay. Oh, honey, tonight, this is gonna be our first night as a family, you and me and Jane. Okay.
Teresa, why did you force me to do this?
Louise, I get your anger toward Catherine, I do.
So do I.
But she's not the one that's coming between you two. You are.
No, I'm not.
Louise, you just need to embrace what you feel for Sheridan, and don't tie it to facts or proof about anything.
Look, Teresa, I'm not like you, okay? I can't just ignore reality. And in fact, if you'd have listened to Mama and Ethan...
And Whitney.
And Whitney, I bet that you wouldn't have lost custody of Jane. But instead, you ignored reality, and now it's come back to bite you big time.
You know what, Louise? I still believe in my dream of being with Ethan. I still believe, after everything that's happened, in the end, he will choose to be a family with me, little Ethan and Jane.
You really believe that?
I do believe that, Louise. And you should believe in your love for Sheridan.
I do. It's just, it's a different kind of love. It's a love where you don't ignore reality, a love where partners talk about facts and try and work out problems together.
Well, have you tried that?
Yeah. But, maybe I can try a little harder. Maybe if I do, we can get back on the same page again.
Good for you, Emil.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, maybe it is more a combination of facts and feelings that I have let facts get in the way of true love.
I think so, Louise.
You know, I bet if I find Sheridan and we talk in private, we can work things out.
I can't believe that Beth confessed to being paid by Alistair to tear you and Louise apart.
You know, I'm still not convinced that that's the secret that Father and Beth and Mrs. Wallace wanted to keep, though.
Darling, does Louise know how you really feel about all this?
Of all times for Catherine to play 20 bloody questions. Let Sheridan be on her way to see Dottie. We need to know the truth about Marty's maternity. Then Sheridan and Louise's love will fall apart at the seams.
You know, if Louise loves me, then he should just trust me.
Look, there is no issue that Louise loves you beyond measure, Sheridan. Men are different than we are. And Louise, on top of it, was trained as a detective, so he was trained to approach a case from the point of view of facts, evidence.
What about gut instinct?
Luis trusts his. He follows it all the time. Now, why won't he believe me when my gut tells me that Marty is my son? Period. I know it.
I just hate to see you and Luis at odds when you love each other so much.
You know, I can't believe it. Luis has been so mean to you, and all you want to see is my being happy with him.
Because Luis makes you happy, that makes me happy. Don't let this issue of Marty or anything get in the way of you and Luis. Darling, please go and talk with him.
What's the point when Luis won't even listen to me?
Talk is cheap. I want action. Endora, give Mummy a boost so I can get things going again, will you? Huh? Tingly and refreshing. Thank you, my little witchling. Sheridan, don't talk to Louise. Talk to Dottie. Find the truth in the DNA. Don't talk to Louise. Talk to Dottie. Find the truth in the DNA.
Did you hear that? Hear what?
Don't talk to Luis. Talk to Dottie. Find the truth in the DNA.
I have to go now. I have to find the truth in the DNA.
Good job, Endora. Things are back on track. Soon those lovers will be derailed.
And that guy, want him to know what hit him.
With these marked cards, I'm gonna take him out faster than Moneymaker took out Brennus at the 2003 World Series of Poker.
If your lady friend has any leftover mattress then, you let me know.
Yeah, no problem. As long as you don't mind a few bruises.
What's the diff in it?
You know who gets these?
No problem.
Fancy. Ready to teach your friend a lesson.
Ooh, can I watch?
Whatever turns you on.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a new player joining the game.
You never listen, do you, Fancy?
Depends on what I'm hearing, Ned. So far from you, it's gone in one ear and out the other.
No brain in the way to get a clue from? It's all over for you, Ned.
Honey, I know taking Jane away from Teresa is hard for you, but once you tuck your baby girl into bed at the mansion tonight, you won't have a single doubt in your mind that you've done the right thing.
Say night-night, Grandma.
Good night, my angel.
Teresa, what you said before about being with Ethan, I hope you're not setting yourself up for more disappointment.
Oh, no. See, we know Daddy better than anyone, don't we, baby? He's not gonna disappoint us.
Are there two Ethans, Teresa? Because the Ethan that I saw in court today, he defended Gwen with passion. And I didn't see a hint of him leaving Gwen to be with you.
Mama, Ivy, Gwen, and Rebecca pressured Ethan into defending Gwen, just like they pressured him into suing me for custody of Jane. But when it comes down to it, Ethan's gonna choose to be with me. Shh, because he loves me, Mama. That's why, even though he won temporary custody of Jane, he's not gonna actually come here and take her away from me. Because the Ethan I know and love just isn't that cool.
Taking a child away from its mother, Gwen, I hate this.
Ethan, honey,
You're Jane's father. You have every right to her, just as much right to her as Teresa.
Even so, it's...
Are you sure you installed that car seat correctly?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Let's go get Jane.
Wait, no, wait. We can't.
Why, Ethan? What? What is it now?
We can't do this. We can't take Jane away from Teresa.
Find the truth in the DNA test.
Sheridan, please promise me you'll talk to Louise before you do anything.
Oh, that Catherine can talk the hind leg off a donkey. Leave Sheridan alone, you meddling mother, you. The sooner she proves the truth, the sooner Louise will get the old heave-ho. Oh, no. Oh, no, Louise is headed for Sheridan now. Oh, he'll break the trance the same way Catherine did.
Sheridan. Catherine. Oh. Well, it's no wonder that Sheridan's been acting the way that she has. You've been filling her head full of lies and confusing her and making me out to be the bad guy because I need proof to accuse Beth of attempted murder and kidnapping.
Wait a minute. Leave my mother out of this. All right, she is not the problem here. You are. You're the reason why our relationship is dying because you won't believe me when I say that Marty is my son.
Ned, you're in way over your head. Why not just fold now? Get it over.
I know what I'm doing.
Do you really?
Are you trying to make me jealous or just distract me?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Ned, I'm impressed with the size of your wager.
Big is better. Right, Fancy?
I've seen bigger.
How about we make this game a little more interesting? Say... winner take all?
Sure. No problem.
Sorry, Ned, but you asked for this.
What do you mean we can't do this? Honey, please don't tell me you're gonna let Teresa keep Jane.
No, you... I meant, I think it's best that I go in alone to go get Jane. If Teresa sees you, she'll make a scene.
Honey, she's gonna make a scene no matter what.
Yeah, you're probably right about that. I still think it's best if I go in alone.
Okay, fine, whatever. Honey, just go. Go get Jane so we can take our daughter home.
Mama. Oh, it's Ethan. And he's alone. Oh, when he come back to me, Mama, take her. Sweetheart? Mommy is going to get your daddy.
Teresa, you're dreaming again.
No, I'm not, Mama. You're going to see. Watch this. Ethan. I knew you'd realize we should be together.
Teresa.
Oh,
Teresa,
I love you so much.
Ethan isn't here because he loves you, Teresa. He's here to take Jane.
Look, I knew you'd come back to me. I knew it. Now we can be a family with Jane and little Ethan.
Sheridan, I came to find you so that we could talk about Marty. All right? So we can try and get back on the same page.
I was trying to convince Sheridan to do the same with you.
All right, why don't you just stay out of this?
You know what? Don't talk to my mother that way. She understands how I feel about Marty.
Did you see Louise wince at Sheridan's verbal daggers? Well, that girl is on a roll. Let's keep her going, shall we? Huh? Help Mummy cue the mist of meanness.
Why can't you be on my side?
Sheridan, I am on your side.
What, my word isn't good enough?
No, I'm sorry, it isn't.
Oh, I'm the woman that you supposedly love.
You are.
Well, in our commitment ceremony in Mexico, we made a promise to forsake all others.
I know.
You know what that means? That means that you believe what I say, not what anyone else says, especially your high school sweetheart, Beth.
Look, Sheridan, this isn't about Beth, okay? It's about me trying to find proof so I can back up
what
you
believe. Well, you wouldn't need proof if you trusted me.
Sheridan, can you please just calm
down? Calm down! No, you know what? I can't take this anymore. I cannot be with a man who doesn't believe in me.
So what, you're saying we're finished? You're leaving me?
Oh, Endora, the mist is working. Oh, Sheridan's anger is making her meaner and meaner and her fuse shorter and shorter. But at this rate, a love that's lasted eons will be over in a matter of seconds.
Fancy, what are you still doing with that guy? Now do yourself a favor, ditch him now before it's too late.
It's like there's some evil force in Army. Something that just won't let us be happy.
Reese and Sheridan are back on track to oblivion.